Hey, folks, it's Lindsey Huddleston with SPS back in the building. Got the Moneyball program day 8. And right, it's quiet right now. We're getting started. And that voice you normally hear in the back is sitting right next to me. It's TZ, the host, also known as Terrence Grantham. That's the man. That's his government. But when he go into a super mode and friends of justice mode, you know, he change it up, man. But you've been doing a great job, not only for the Moneyball program, for Michigan State basketball. I know you do things with the G League, the Motor City Cruise. And then you're a proud Detroiter handling your business. I'm saying that correct. So tell us who TZ the host is.
Man, TZ the host, that story starts in Michigan State in undergrad.
Okay. That sounds fun already.
Yeah. That story starts from people who were older than me seeing something in me I didn't know was there.
What did they see?
So it was I don't know. Personality, I guess.
Yeah.
I've taken a total of one public speaking class, and that was in like ninth grade.
Wow.
Never put anything with it.
Uh-huh.
Didn't do any type of media work.
It was just something, just check the box and you kept moving.
Yeah. But, uh-huh. You know, we have some upperclassmen who, one of, you know, still very, very near and dear to my heart to this day, for sure.
Mm-hmm.
One of my OGs, man, Walter Bivens.
Okay.
And the whole advantage, man, that whole organization, that whole program, E.T., DeAndre Carter, all
of
them.
Yeah.
They welcomed me right in with open arms. And as the former host before me, shout out Tim City, he was getting ready to graduate, and they said, yo, let's slide you in there.
Yeah.
We just kind of
leaned
him out so it wouldn't be an abrupt shift for the audience.
Right. So when you talk about the role, and I get the pleasure of seeing you being close covering Michigan State with media credentials, talk about what goes into that and how much of this is what you've seen someone else do and how much is your personality and your fingerprints on it.
It's a pretty even mix. You know, I've played basketball my whole life.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously watched basketball my whole life, and then some of those kind of sayings and phrases.
Sure.
Those just kind of stick with
it
you.
It come natural.
Whether you know who's
saying
it or
not. Sound like some George Blaha type. Yeah.
It just
you feel that's what you're supposed to say in this moment.
But between that, you know, I'm from the era of and-one.
Yeah.
So I get to throw that flair
in
there.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, doing the G League and Michigan State, those are both pretty formal setups, right? We got tight scripts, schedule, we got networks, we got commercials, we got paid spots.
Mm-hmm.
Here. So I get to take my rawness and then take that professional kind of scripted work and then come out here and blend it up real nice.
And you do a good job with that. I'm not saying that to be saying it. The game could be going, but it's your personality and what you reflect. And you don't have a DJ Crew Center. You're not talking over the track, meaning like your voice is omnipresent in my view, but it's not irritating. You don't have the Nori drink champs. like, Nori, let him finish. You know, but I say that as a compliment.
And I appreciate that. And that's something I try to be conscious of because at the end of the day, they're here to watch the game.
They're here for the game. You know? Well, but you know, it's an amazing thing when that microphone gets in a human's hand, man. You start hearing that.
And we work together. My relationship with the players has helped. You know, this is my third year doing a pro-am now. I've fostered a relationship with a lot of those Michigan State players, a lot of those returning guys that are from the area who come and they play every year, the JJs, the Devins,
the
Spartans, man. So some of these fans are crossover fans as well.
That's true.
Like, I see you at the Bresner, I see you at the Cruz game. So, but that relationship with the players helps me interact with them while they're playing. I'm talking to the fans. I'm making everybody feel like we're all here together.
How are people when they approach you trying to figure out where they know you from or knowing you? What is life like when you're just living your life and people respond to you based on what you've been doing?
It's cool, man. It's very kind of, I don't want to come in there because I see you kind of with the kids or whatever. I welcome them, man. I love it. That's my job.
Yeah.
Like, my job is to be an entertainer of people.
Mm-hmm.
My job is game presentation, in-game entertainment. That's my job.
Yeah.
So sometimes I got to remind myself, TG, we can't watch the game. Like, as a fan.
I know.
You got to watch for that timeout.
You got to be
in place and your team got to be ready. You got to have your cards and your contestant. You got to be ready.
Well, we both working because people say, how was the game? So I didn't see it. I was working.
Man, it's been times where I look up, we up 20, 5 seconds later, we down.
I know. This has happened like that. Talk about the other things you're involved in. I've seen you on stage. I know you're very much involved in the community. Talk about a little bit more things you got going on.
Yeah, so I tell people I can host anything. Just last week, I was doing a fundraiser for a organization in Detroit, Matrix Human Services.
Yeah, shout out to Matrix. I was just on the call with somebody talking about Matrix.
That's my third year doing that. Rooftop fundraiser.
Hey, it's great when they put you on the calendar and you come back
around. I've been on tour with Jay Will and T-Barb out of Detroit hosting comedy shows.
Yeah.
My brother CP, one of the first people to let me get on stage with him. And do some comedy around that and just kind of picking up tips and tricks from people.
So talk about the comedy part. Where does that come in at?
I don't know. I don't know. I mean, naturally, there's some. I don't tell people I'm a comedian. Cause sure. You say that.
Tell me something funny and they hold you to the standard.
There, you uh-huh. in that life all the time. Yeah. But, you know, they also told me in order to host, you have to be a comedian. You have to be able to do that.
Sure, so sure.
Just trying to learn as much as I can in all of these facets. And then when the opportunity presents itself, I can take a little bit from everywhere and give everybody the product that they deserve.
Let's go back to the original part of having a microphone, being on stage, dealing with stage fright. Clearly, that's something that doesn't stop you from doing your job. But was that ever a thing for you?
I don't think I've ever had stage fright.
Never, huh?
Never. I do get, not even really anymore, but I used to get like little stomach flutters. But
well, Isaiah Thomas said, you know, he'll get the bubble guts before a game.
Yeah. Like I said, sometimes I get nervous every time, but it never stays.
But I think the nervousness, and I say the same thing, I think that's a healthy thing because it is you're respecting what you have to
absolutely,
do.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because you don't want to go out there, you know, and make a,
and
you know, and all that type of stuff, go like that. Well, I appreciate what you're doing. I think this is appreciated. The one thing about your role, it's easy to take it for granted because you're just a part of it. But when you're not here, we notice that.
No, I've learned that. I've learned that in quite a few of my arenas. I've gotten back and they're like, hey, man, don't do that. No, where's you at? What are you doing?
Yeah, they said we need you here. Yeah. Well, what's next with you? I know basketball season will be here
basketball
soon.
Basketball season's coming up. One of my recurring partners again, I'll be at Detroit City Football Club in Black Star for a First Touch Youth Soccer Clinic this coming weekend, hosting that.
Man, your calendar stay full, huh?
I try.
Yeah.
The bills keep coming.
The bills keep coming, so I need
kids
to be out there.
Kids keep growing.
Yeah.
My wife still live with me.
Yeah.
Everybody needs something.
She still talk to you and everything?
Yeah, every other day.
You doing good.
Yeah, I'm making progress.
That's great. The other day, man.
That's great. Just finding that balance, the family, the entertainment, the business, the day job still, work. Is, but it's, you know, when you lock in, you get that beautiful combustion in it.
Yeah.
Everybody's satisfied.
I think that's an excellent way to describe what you've been doing. Well, we appreciate you here. I'm glad I had a chance to sit down and people can kind of meet the voice and go from
Absolutely.
There. And I want to wish you the best. You always got a platform here.
Thank you. Thank you, man. Shout out to SPS, man.
I appreciate it, man.
We on the refs' uniforms. We on official shirts this year.
Official with
whole
right?
Game, every game.
Hey man, I'll be snapping shots of pictures that I ain't even in. I like, oh, there's a logo back there.
That's what matters, man.
I appreciate
you, Lindsay Manny. You've been here since I've been here. First 2 years, two something.
Nah, well, I was doing it a while ago. I was doing it since you've been here. But we was over at AM High together.
This is when
we used to sit with that guy right there, Forrest Boyer over there. We used to sit in the spot, you know, holding it down. But it's been a good thing, man. And you're an integral part of that, and you appreciate it.
I appreciate it, man. I'm glad to be here. As long as they have me, I'll be here. Moneyball is the family, man. For everybody out the Metro Detroit area, come to the Southfield store. I'm there every Wednesday, 30215 Southfield Road, 12-7. Come shop with your boy.
Yeah, we're going to do that. Any shout-outs you want to give?
My wife, my kids, my parents, my family, everybody in Michigan State.
Say everybody's names.
Oh, man, Alexis, that's my wife. My oldest son is Drew. He's normally here with me. He's not here tonight.
Okay.
I had to come too early. My daughter, Corey, my baby boy, Shane, my dog, Snoop.
There you go.
Michigan State, of course, near and dear to my heart.
You shout-out your frat, too.
Noobs, man.
We MPAC here. Shout-out to the Alphas as well, man.
Yeah. They are right. They cool.
It's a good thing. It's a good thing. I knew it was going to start something, but I had to show the love. We all right.
No. I got some homies, man. Y'all good people.
No.
Appreciate you, man.
Yeah, we're going to be good. We're going to be good. We're going to do that. That combustion. That's what he's talking about, guys. TZ, the host right here. We're getting ready for the Moneyball Program Day 8. We'll see you guys next time. Peace. Point, 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 point